a bus wave. It's just one big walker, I think. So I think the best thing to do, because these towers are not enough to take it down, is to build this. Should I make another teleporter? No, there's one over there. Alright. So, let's bring it on. My towers are doing a good job of taking them out. I'm going to teleport over here to greet him. All right, that's nice. Well, to upgrade this next costs 400, so that is incredibly expensive. That's 320. So I am going to upgrade some towers, I think. The color of the towers also changes. And the looks also change, so they gradually look more badass as you progress them. I will make this one here, and you know what, I will upgrade the freeze one. Pretty much what that does is it increases the length that enemies are frozen. And every weapon also has an alternative, like, fire mode. So, like, this one has the grenades, which doesn't do a lot of damage, but deals damage to multiple enemies, which can be a good strategy. And this, of course, you know, freezes them, and you can... Oh, shit, that was not very smart. And you can also choose just to slow them down, because if you choose to freeze them, the cooldown on the weapon is quite long. Alright, that was fairly easy. So now we have the big walkers and the ones that slow down at corners. Oh, that one's level 1. Oh, that's pretty weak. Let's upgrade that one. This one as well. And let's upgrade the sniper, even though I don't use the sniper a lot. There are some enemies where, like, you only can fire, can really attack them with the sniper, but those enemies are not really in this level yet. But, for example, with my weapon upgrade now, I can fire 2 shots instead of 1, and it can go up to 4. Yeah, this area should now be absolutely devastating for them, because I have a lot of lightning towers now that are upgraded a bit. Still on cooldown. The cooldown also gets reduced when you upgrade weapons. I might also be thinking about upgrading this bit for, like, backup. Well, even though it's not really necessary. So now I am able to upgrade this bad boy to level 5, even though that may not have been the smartest thing, because we have fast enemies, so it will not really be effective against those little small critters, but I will deal with them and he will deal with the big ones with the reduced damage. Even if I can take a few shots at first. No small creatures inside yet, which is good. And there they come. Obviously, when you do this game with like 4 players, it gets incredibly like chaotic, but that's also the charm of it, more fun. They are coming through with quite a lot. And that was quite easy. Next one, our regular walkers again. So you know what? I will. Oh no, that was 400. I'll upgrade you, and I will build some new towers. Even though it's not really necessary, I built some new ones. I will show you the scatter. This one also attacks air units, even though I don't think there are air units in this level yet. Alright. I have a bit more defense here, even though this first area is pretty much the point where everyone dies. And this is pretty much how I play every level. Because it gets gradually harder the way you progress, and I find that upgrading towers is a bit more effective than build a lot of towers. Even though, of course, you know, a famous thing is that when the air mode, like the flying enemies come, that wave everybody gets taken out, because that means that things like lightning towers won't be able to fire at them. But luckily you have the towers that attack both ground enemies and flying enemies. And that was pretty easy also. We are over half of this level. I think, yeah, that's a big walker again. So I will also upgrade this bad boy, so we have now 2 level 5. Alright, I can upgrade you, whatever. When you play this game co-op, you share the resources, so you get, I think, the same number of resources, but you share them so you can build far less, like, on your own, but combined you can build as much as you play it alone. Yeah, this shouldn't be a problem either. They get absolutely owned by these 2 towers. Oh. Even though giving them a hand couldn't. It's really nice how there's like a big pile of monsters here. Well, Gatling guns are pretty useless against these guys, so I will upload lightning towers again. Which will, I know what, whatever. It's not really efficient what I'm doing, but this level is not really that hard, so I can easily do some weird choices. recently there has been some downloadable content for this game, a few new maps and new weapons, and it integrates them in the single player as well by adding two maps in the selection screen and actually now letting you select what type of weapon or tower you want, because for strategic reasons it doesn't give you all the towers and lets you only select a few. I think I can, yeah, I can upgrade this guy, which I will do. Don't really need to upgrade any other towers because that will not make any difference, because I can create one level, like level 1 lightning tower or a Gatling gun and upgrade it, but I'll not, I won't be doing that. Oh, that was pretty useless. Everybody got taken out. Time for the big boys again. This tower actually costs a lot to upgrade, so I don't know if I will be able to upgrade him to the max level, but I will just be happy by upgrading these ones up to... Oh, I can actually upgrade this one also. Great. Pretty much my shooting actually is quite useless because I haven't upgraded my sniper really yet, so my shots aren't really doing a lot of damage. It's actually good that I like upgraded some towers over there, because now if some of them get through here I don't need to worry as much as them getting really far, because I have some quite serious defenses over there as well. I haven't seen all the levels yet. I have played through this level and I got stuck at one point, but at that time I didn't try the strategy that I'm doing now, so I don't know how that will work out yet. I hope to get it the next time that I try it. We're almost done with this level, as you can see. This is wave 16 of 20. Oh, there's a lot of little bastards going. Yeah, those running shouldn't not be that big of a problem, because my towers can easily take them out because they're so slow. The fast critters, on the other hand, are quite a problem.